Welcome to Vape Channel Vaiska. Now, this is video kedua aku. And today, we are going to review liquids. As you know, channel ni actually aku start for reviews lah generally. But we are going to talk about liquids. Mainly, we are going to talk about pots. We are going to talk about mods. We are going to talk about actis. But, that's not all. Because aku rasa we have to make it more interesting. So if there's any update on news ke, there's any updates on any development on regulation ke, ataupun drama ke, so I will incorporate that semasa aku buat review. Okay, so it's just not about review. But today, review lah. Today we are going to review on these liquids. It is from US. Namanya Finest. Okay. Is from California, Los Angeles, and I think these people baru lah. They are not been long in the market, and they have a variation of liquids, yeah, as you can see. But today, of course, aku takkan review semua lah. We are going to review this tiramisu custard. Okay, you can see that very clean labeling. Of course, all the standard requirement ada lah, yeah. Dia punya flavor apa profile, dia punya warning semua ada dekat belakang ni, alright. And this is the free base. And at the same time, we are also going to review the tiramisu custard yang soft ni. Okay, now where shall I start? Actually, this liquid was introduced to me by Vapers Union. By James Tan, my old friend. Okay. Now, before aku nak review pasal liquid ni, aku nak cerita sikit pasal sedikit sejarah pasal Vapers Union. And this is part of the direction of aku punya channel lah. Because we are just not going to talk about the liquids or the actis or the pots or the mods. We can talk about more than that. Kali ni, sebab James yang do introduce aku liquid ni, I want to talk about Vapers Union. Sedikit sejarah tentang Vapers Union, sedikit sejarah tentang James Tan. Okay, and we have known each other for quite some time. And James ni, setiap kali dia recommend aku liquid, memang kena dengan aku punya taste palette lah, dengan aku punya taste bud. The first liquid aku ingat dia recommend aku was Kilo. That was fantastic liquid. Okay, so sedikit sejarah pasal Vapers Union. Yang aku rasa ramai orang tak tahu. It started back about 6 years ago, I think. Masa tu aku dah mula aktif in the online punya vape community. Then tiba-tiba ada satu orang contact aku, dia cakap, Sam, I want to see you. Aku tak kenal dia siapa. Then we meet up dekat, what's the hotel yang dekat Curve tu?
Royal Bintang.
Yeah, we meet up at Royal Bintang. So, jumpalah seorang China man rambut putih ni. Okay, duduk borak-borak, dia cakap dia interested lah. Dia nampak potensial yang besar dalam vape industry ni. And kita pada masa sama boleh bantu untuk orang berhenti merokok. This was me and James at that time. Duduk kat lobby hotel. Hotel apa tadi?
Royal Bintang.
Okay. Duduk borak, dia kata he is very keen to start. Now, why did we start Vapers Union? And in fact, James is the founder of Vapers Union. And at the inception of Vapers Union, I was involved. This is where banyak orang tak tahulah. I was involved with James in the foundation of Vapers Union ni. And the reason why, among the main reason why we incorporated Vapers Union is because at that time, the only US liquid yang available kat Malaysia was Tasty Vapor. And ada seorang budak kajang yang jual Tasty Vapor ni. And dia jual Tasty Vapor ni, and dia dilutekan Tasty Vapor tu. So dia bawa sini, I don't want to say the names lah, dia bawa liquid tu ke sini daripada US, dia dilute, then dia jual. So liquid tu dah cair tau. And we thought that this is not right lah, James. So I told him, why not we bring in Tasty Vapor, tapi kita jangan dilute, kita jual as it is packed in US. Bukan macam apa budak kajang ni buat, dia bawa sini, dia repack balik, dia dilute, then dia jual. That's not what we wanted to do. That was the main objective of the incorporation of Vapers Union, which is we want to bring forward to the market, nak bawa ke pasaran produk yang dipercayai oleh pengguna. Now, eventually that has been the brand of Vapers Union. If you buy apa saja di Vapers Union, it is guaranteed the authenticity is guaranteed. Jangan takutlah, you beli mod ke, you beli pot ke, you beli liquid ke, that's the branding of Vapors Unit, right? So, but then I was not involved sampai sekarang lah, di mana kedai dia ada di mall yang dekat belakang Paradigm tu. Okay, their shop is there, and it is a very well branded entity. Dan mungkin ramai juga orang tak tahu logo Vapors Union tu aku yang design. Yeah, so not many people know all these small facts. So enough about all this bullshit. That's about a bit about the sejarah of Vapors Union. Tapi dulu masa kita orang meniaga sebelum ada kedai, kita pergi dekat Pearl Point tu, tempat kita distribute liquid kat meja McDonald's tu. Okay, meja Starbucks. And then I remember James was the first one who brought in kilo. Dia orang pertama yang bawa kilo masuk ke Malaysia. Dia orang yang pertama yang bawa 5 pounds. Masa tu orang tak tahu pun 5 pounds. Nampak dia punya packaging, wesh, impressive gila. Tapi ada beberapa mula-mula, to be honest, masa aku duduk try 5 pounds dulu dengan James, James tak suka. Dia cakap rasa macam lipas. But itu cerita 5 years ago lah. But we know 5 pounds is among the best liquids in Malaysia, and he was the first one who brought it in. This is a bit sejarah about Vapors Union. And if you want if you are in Klanggari, I would suggest you drop by to Vapors Union punya kedai dekat belakang Paradigm Mall tu. And you can be assured, branding Vapors Union is all about authenticity and quality service. Okay, so today kita nak review liquids. And you might think that review liquid lah yang paling senang. Betul tak kan? Review IT susah sebab nak coil. Macam video aku sebelum ni, tangan sampai menggigil, orang semua gelak. First time. Okay. Or nak review mods or pots. It's easier. But actually tak. Review liquid lah yang paling susah sekali. You know why? Because first of all, benda tu subjektif. Okay. Rasa tu subjektif. And then, there are so many factors yang mempengaruhi rasa liquid tu. Contohnya, tank apa you pakai, okay, dapat mempengaruhi rasa liquid tu. How you coil, berapa lilitan cotton apa you pakai, volume cotton tu pun sendiri boleh mempengaruhi rasa liquid tu. Kalau terlalu banyak cotton, dia akan mute. Kalau terlalu sikit, liquid tu akan tembak naik ke lidah. So there are so many factors. Even airflow size pun akan mengawal ataupun mempengaruhi rasa liquid. Even drip tip boleh mempengaruhi rasa liquid tu. So, it's not that easy tau nak buat review liquid tu. Tapi kalau kau nak buat review cincai-cincai boleh lah macam. Sedap. Sedap. Pergilah beli. Kalau nak buat review macam tu, senang lah. But I think we have to be more in depth lah. More in depth. Kita kena review hari ni. Kita nak review dia punya flavor profile, of course. Kita nak review dia punya complexity of dia punya flavor tu. Kita nak mungkin look into ada tak undertone or aftertaste. Kita nak review throat heat. Kita nak review vapor production. So all these are the things that kita nak review untuk kedua-dua flavor tiramisu custard ni, untuk free base dan juga untuk sok ni, same flavor. Okay, now, kenapa liquid review is important? Sebab dalam vaping experience, in a vaping experience, tak kira lah mod kau RM10,000 ke, turun daripada kayangan ke, kau punya AT high end, tapi kalau liquid kau rasa macam shit, the vaping experience is shit lah. So this is why liquid selection is very important, which brings to a liquid review, which is more important and it's not that easy to do. So let's get to it, okay? Today we are going to review this liquid from this people from US. It's a US liquid, the finest katanya. Let's see lah, mari kita tengok betul ke finest ke tidak. Okay, and the liquid profile yang kita flavor profile kita nak review is tiramisu custard. Tiramisu ni cake kan? Is a coffee based cake. Betul tak?
Yeah,
coffee based. And custard katanya dia punya flavor profile tu. And also mungkin ada hint of Graham cracker. Okay. So now, to be fair, when you vape a liquid, for me lah eh, bila nak review, you tak boleh macam bila you nak buat review tu, this is your first experience of buka liquid tu, terus masuk, terus buat review. I don't think that's fair. Let me explain why. Bagi aku vape. Sebab, daripada aku punya observation and experience eh, didapati bahawa liquid yang betul-betul sedap eh, dia grows on you tau. So, the first impression when you vape might not be accurate. Tak tepat. So, aku dah vape liquid ni about satu hari, you know, continuously to really see whether it will grow on me or not. So, that's what I've been vaping the whole day lah. Since yesterday, I've been vaping this Tiramisu Custard. And kita ni sebagai vapor, as we evolve sebagai vapor, mungkin kita akan branch kepada ada yang suka fruity, ya. Yeah? Ada yang suka lemak, ada yang suka bakery flavor, ada yang suka tobacco. So we will branch to our own preference. And to be honest, aku tak pernah suka coffee flavor or tiramisu flavor, honestly. Okay, but let us give this a shot and see how it goes. Okay, itu preference. So now, I want to try this tiramisu from the finest ni, tiramisu custard from the finest. Okay, let's give it a shot. This is a free base liquid yang ni eh. Aku guna this tank ni aku buat about 0.8 resistance. And it's a mouth to lung punya tank. And in my opinion, bila you vape a liquid, alright, yang you nak rasa a good experience, you nak ada experience of vaping it, okay, it's better, my suggestion lah, yeah, you guna mouth to lung, okay, sebab kita rasa, deri rasa kita dekat mulut, yeah, biarlah flavor tu pergi kat mulut dulu, baru dia pergi ke lung. Kalau you set up yang direct to lung, then you won't really appreciate, tak hargai rasa liquid tu, okay? So, let's try. Now, flavor profile dia ialah tiramisu custard. And I have to say, it's very realistic dia punya tiramisu tu, and dia punya custard tu comes as an undertone, and you do taste dia punya graham cracker. But the most important thing about this liquid ialah aku terasa satu benda, aku terasa quality. I can taste the quality because when I vape, especially for flavor yang ada coffee or tiramisu, this is very important, okay guys? It must be smooth, okay? Sebab kebanyakan coffee base punya flavor, dia tajam tau. And dulu masa aku vape liquid-liquid yang coffee base, masa aku mula-mula vape dulu lah, sakit kepala tau. But not this liquid. This liquid, I can tell you, is very, very smooth. Very smooth. Flavor-wise, this is a suitable liquid untuk engkau vape lepas makan. This is, honestly, it's not something that you want to vape as a daily vape. Bukan untuk daily vape punya liquid. Because dia flavorful lah. So, lepas makan, it's a good vape lah. You know, and of course, you can have your daily vape. Whatever you vape as your daily vape. Then, this liquid, kerana dia punya flavor is very full, it's good for you to nak pergi toilet, buang air besar. Very good. Lepas makan, very good. Okay. It is good. Even though I am not tiramisu fan, but I think this is the best tiramisu based flavor I've tried. Alright, so we are still on the free base tiramisu custard by Finest. Let's break down in category, eh. Daripada segi flavor, It's wonderful lah. Okay, 1 to 10. Nanti kejap. Vape lagi sikit. Vape. Because aku pun terror coil kan. So, flavor ni semua tu lah. It's really, really flavorful. So, 1 to 10, I would give it about 8.5. Very flavorful. Very smooth. And also, kita kalau nak cerita pasal complexity, it's really not a complex flavor lah because it's very accurate. Dia punya description about tiramisu tu memang accurate, eh? Memang realistic tiramisu flavor. And bila dia infuse dengan rasa custard and graham cracker tu, the combination of these flavors menjadikan dia rasa macam slightly RY4 tobacco punya flavor tu. So it's really nice lah. And importantly, because all these are very strong flavors, custard is strong, tiramisu is strong, graham cracker is strong. The factor yang you have to look into in this strong flavors, the combination of these strong flavors, it's smoothness. And this liquid is really, really smooth. And sesuai untuk as a second liquid. You know, as we grow as a vapor, kan? Kita ada 2-3 jenis liquid yang kita vape on a daily basis. I would really strongly recommend this to be your second liquid that you vape besides the daily vape that you vape lah. Okay, so now let's go on to the Sonic. Alright, same flavor profile. Before that, I minum coffee so to cut the flavor yang tadi tu lah. Okay, I'm using this Vuku pakai 0.3 coil. I use 0.3 because it brings out the flavor lagi, it tastes lagi accurate. Okay, shooting it at 33 watt, and I've been vaping this the whole day as well. I have to say, besides what I have described dengan freebase tadi, the flavouring is more intense dekat Sonic ni. Tadi dia macam freebase tu dia ada sedikit mild, okay? But here, the flavour lebih intense, but the smoothness is still there, okay? Dari segi flavouring. It's really good. Okay, and vapor production you can see lah. Alright. And the throat hit is just right. Okay, tak sampai tajam sangat. It's just right. So for a very strong flavor, I think it's really smooth. Even the softening is really good. Okay, that's my take on it lah. That's my opinion. And kita kalau nak bandingkan antara freebase dengan softening ni, dua ni, okay, side by side lah, the whole total vaping experience, I would say that yang freebase ni better lah, yeah, it's better. Freebase and then pakai MTL, so you really enjoy the experience. It's something you appreciate lah. I call it appreciative vaping. You appreciate it because it's more cool lah. Alright, and the quality is something that you can really taste. You boleh rasa quality dia. Alright, so now kalau kita nak rate daripada segi flavouring untuk Sonic ni, from 1 to 10, 10 being perfect, 1 being not so good, I would say the flavouring here is intense, more intense than the previous. And of course, because pakai 0.3 coil, the vapor production is a lot more. Okay, it's a lot more. Vapor production ni 9 out of 10 lah for Sonic. And daripada segi ratio PGVG dia, I was informed that the freebase ni is 70-30 and the Sonic is 50-50. So basically, overall experience, I would say this is quite a fantastic product. Quite a fantastic flavor because I was a bit skeptical lah. Aku agak skeptical bila it is a tiramisu custard flavor ni. But why I tried this first is because tiramisu previously was my least favorite lah. It's not something I go for. But this one is really smooth. So the overall experience is something I would rate. In fact, this has been my third refill lah. Yeah, dekat freebase tank ni. And so this is the second refill dekat salt ni. For me, being a very apa tu, cerewet ni vapor, kalau liquid tu tak sedap, aku tak habiskan pun. But this one has been the third refill. So this is a really good liquid. I would recommend it lah. Kalau you are a type of person who goes into cream based liquid, liquid yang if you favor coffee based, I would recommend this liquid. It's really really smooth. And later on aku akan letak link dekat bawah so that you can access to Vapor Sweden punya website or Facebook page. Okay guys, so that's about it for today's review. I'm not going to review the whole range because it's going to take a long time. I will review the rest one by one. So the next topic on vape review by Ska would be something that is related to vape, tetapi it's a much more interesting topic. The topic would be kenapa seorang vapor ada 3, 4, 5, 6 device. So this video, I would want you to invite your wife juga datang tengok. Sebab wife kita kan selalu bising, bang, dah lah bang, berapa banyak mod you nak beli? Mulut ada satu je kan? So this is the topic. Next topic, next video that I will post up. Okay guys, so thank you for spending your time to listen to me to do this vape review, liquid review. If you want to listen to the next topic which is very interesting, kenapa seorang vapor kena ada 3, 4, 5 mod sebab mulut ada satu je, so get your wife to come in and subscribe to my channel. Alright, thank you guys.